Hello. Let us learn what items for homonuclear molecules. What are homonuclear molecules? Homo means same nucleus. For example, you can take hydrogen. Two hydrogens, H2. Same way, N2O2. Let us see the MO diagrams for these molecules. What are these? First of all, as the valency bond theory unable to explain the magnetic property, we can able to explain the properties basing on these MO diagrams. Right? Here we have up to 14. The electrons, up to 14 electrons will follow one order, and above the 14 number of electrons that are present in homonuclear molecule, then we will follow the order a different way. Let us first see what is the order we have to follow. The number of electrons present are 14 in a homonuclear molecule. What is the order? Generally, we know two atomic orbitals combine that results in the molecular orbital. Right? Now, let us see up to 14 I said to you. So, if a molecule consists of 14 electrons and less than 14 electrons, it is going to follow the energy level diagram for in this way. Sigma 1s, right? Sigma star 1s, sigma 2s. Sigma star 2s, pi 2py equals to pi 2pz, and sigma 2px. Then go for antibonding, pi star 2py equals to pi star 2pz and sigma star 2px. This is for 14 number, up to 14 number. If the molecule consists of more than 14, what we have to follow? So if the number of electrons are more than 14, so equals to 14, then greater than 14 number of electrons, the following order will be sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, then sigma 2px, then pi 2py equals to pi 2pz, then pi star 2py equals to pi star 2pz, and then sigma star 2ph. Was it clear? If any homonuclear molecule consists of 14 electrons and less than 14, we are going to follow this order. If the homonuclear molecule consists of more than 14 electrons, we are going to follow this order. Let us take one example and then we will check. The best example you can try for this is a nitrogen molecule. Nitrogen means N2. Let us see, N2 means two nitrogens are present. Let us go for first one nitrogen. What is the electronic configuration of a single nitrogen? Nitrogen consists of how many electrons? 7 electrons. So let us write the electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Means 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1. So let us write it as 2p3. Single nitrogen consists of these 7, and then we are having 2 nitrogens. Therefore 7 plus 7 number of electrons we have to follow? First one, sigma. Now, according to MOT, two atomic orbitals are combining, resulting in the formation of two molecular orbital equal number. Am I right? Now, you are going to get one bonding molecular orbital and another antibonding molecular orbital. The formed one, the bonding molecular orbital will be having less energy, right? And the antibonding will be having high energy, right? So this is first level, 1s electron. Here also 1s electron will present. How many electrons are there in 1s? We are having 2 electrons. So write the 2 electrons here. 1s consists of 2 electrons. Here also this nitrogen also same 2 electrons. Now the distribution of the electrons. What we said? Bonding molecular orbital energy will be less, therefore it will be occupied first. So what is the bonding molecular orbital here we are having? 1s. Which one is? Sigma 1s. Right? How many electrons? From one electron from over here and one electron over here. 2. You got 2 now? Check here. Now, this is antibonding. Antibonding will be represented by star, you know, right? So, sigma star 1s. One more electron from here and one more electron from here. Got? The same way, you are going to fill up for the second level. What is the second level we are having? In the second level, we have s orbital as well as the p orbital. Let us check for the s. So, this is a 2s level s orbital. This is one more nitrogen, 2s level. Again, two molecular orbitals you are going to get. One is bonding and the one is antibonding. So what is this bonding? This is 2 years we are saying, right? This is also 2 years for another nitrogen. So how many we are having in 2 years here? You see, 2 electrons. So write down the 2 electrons here also, this nitrogen also. Now the same way you feel, right? What is here? This is bonding sigma 2s. This is the second level s orbital. Therefore bonding sigma 2s. So one electron from here, another electron from here, right? Come to the next antibonding. We are representing with a star. So 2s, one electron from here, another electron from here. So let us check once here, was it fulfilled? So sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2. Now what the level remained for us? Again we are having 3 electrons in 2p level. Let us draw the diagram for p level also. So the p level consists of how many orbitals? 3 orbitals, x, y and z. What is this? Just check, I am rubbing over here. I will write up with a little size of the words 2pz. 2 I wrote and then sigma 2p, yes. Let us see here p orbital. This is one of the p orbital of nitrogen. This is one more p orbital. How to write? 3, 3 we are having now. So x, y, z. So the place is not sufficient. So I am writing this side. Here also, how many we are having? 3 I said to you. X, y and z. Total how many here? 3 plus 3, total 6. So you have to get 6 molecular orbitals, as 6 atomic orbitals are involved. How to write? What are the energy levels? As we discussed, up to the 14, one type of energy level. And after the 14, means above the 14 number of electrons, we have to write another way. So, as nitrogen is having only 14 electrons, the order can be like this. Right? 2 levels we are having. So, how to write? Write like this. Again. Pi 2p they are equal, you are feeling equally. Next, what level you are having? The electrons will enter into X. This is first sigma. So 2px. One electron remain here, one electron remain here. Is it clear? So 2px. Now all the electrons were filled up. Did you check? 14 we got. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 were filled. Let us see the bond order. What is the bond order? How to write the bond order? Bond order is equal to the number of electrons. What I am saying? Number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital minus the number of electrons present in anti-bonding molecular orbital by 2. Now, count the number of electrons in bonding. Bonding means without star, right? So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Am I right? So 10 minus antibonding. With the star you have to count. How many we are having? 1, 2, 3, 4. 10 minus 4 by 2. That is 6 by 2 equals to 3. Now you see the bonds. How many bonds will present between nitrogen and nitrogen? Nitrogen and nitrogen will be bonded with a triple bond, 3 bonds. Clear? Coming to the magnetic character, as there is no unpaired electron over here, it comes under the category of diamagnetic. Next we will learn in the next class. Thank you.